हाय अलोका, हाय अलोका, कैन यू सी मी?
हाय रुचि, देयर आर टू लॉगिन्स अलाउ.
सो गणेश, आई हैव शेयर्ड अ चेस बोर्ड.
हेलो एंड वेलकम एवरीवन बैक टू अनदर स्कूल सिनर्जी सेशन एक्सप्लोरिंग पैटर्न्स इन स्क्वायर नंबर्स. एंड we have been having this school synergy session since a long time. Earlier in 2018 we used to have it physical face to face sessions. Now we are doing online session since 2020 August, and it has been a long series of school synergy workshops, and we have been fortunate enough to have so many people in attendance and people joining the Telegram group also. So today we have with us Aloka Kanhare, and she has been working in Eklavya and Homi Baba Center for Science Education, Mumbai, as a mathematics educator for a long time. And I've known her personally and seen the kind of work that she has done. In Homi Baba, she has done quite extensive work in Vigyan Pratibha. And there are some very interesting patterns that students have come up themselves in exploring these patterns itself. And I hope Aloka will share that experience with you also, perhaps. And without much further ado, I would just like Aloka to come in and share what she has for us in terms of exploring patterns. Over to you.
Thanks, Ruchi. Good afternoon, everybody. Ruchi sir, I'm Aloka. And I'm going to talk to you about, it's not just going to be my experiences about working with children on patterns, but also what one can achieve in mathematics through patterns. But instead of talking about definitions and terminologies, I think what I would like to do is look through examples and whether one can achieve something, like understand a bit of more of mathematics and school mathematics in that process. Purnima, good afternoon. So, a couple of things. One thing is that it would be nice if all of you are with a pen and paper, because there'll be some writing, some doodle. You can also doodle on the side. I doodle all the time, so you can doodle also. But some writing might be needed. Another thing is that I would like it to be an interactive session, so you can either type in the chat box, or you can unmute yourself or raise hands. Raise hands might be a difficult, but Chitra and Ruchi can help me there. If somebody has raised their hands, you can raise your hands on the camera and I will see it. So
We will help you out. And if people raise hands, we will help you out. Even if they type on chat, we will try to help you out and read it for you. Yeah,
so
please go ahead.
Okay, so I'll start now. So this is a particular activity that we have done with children. In a couple of instances, this is a part of the project that Ruchi just mentioned called Vigyan Pratibha, and I'll talk to you more about Vigyan Pratibha and the website. So I'll just start, and we will across the year come across the more of these activities. So just 1 minute. So let's look at the first set of patterns. And so can you see this two rows? On the top is numbers, and on below is the square of those numbers. So what I would like you to do is observe these columns carefully, and then see if you can think of some patterns which hold for all the numbers in this. Any pattern, however simple it is, it doesn't matter. If you might think it's simple, it might not be simple. So like, think about some patterns. I'm going to give you a couple of minutes when most people either nod on the camera or like say yes on the chat. I will continue. So at least one or two patterns looking at these two columns. So they're just numbers and squares. And increasing in or squares of the above numbers. Yeah, that's the So that is the matter.
I think initially Suniti Sharma says increasing in odd bid 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. And Pradyut Mukherjee says difference are odd number. Then Shravanti says square of above numbers plus 2. And so, Santosh Kumar says plus 5, plus 7, plus 9, plus 11.
Yeah, so I'll go one by one. So Pradyut, you say difference are odd numbers. What do you mean by that? You can either unmute or write. You can either unmute or write.
You can unmute and share how you're
thinking. Yes, ma'am. Actually, the difference is odd numbers, like the first two, 4 minus 1 is 3. The next two, 9 minus 4 is 5. So there are odd numbers coming. The differences are coming as odd. 16 minus 9 is 7.
Right. Yeah, absolutely. Did the people understand what Pradyut sir said about the difference? Was it Pradyut sir or Arun sir? I mean,
My name is Arun.
Okay. But okay, so there was somebody else who wrote that. That's fine. So they said that I'm trying to use my So they're saying that if you sir, I will just come to clarify. So you're saying that 4 minus 1 is 3, 9 minus 4 is 5, right? So the difference between consecutive squares is an odd number. Are you saying that, sir?
Yes, exactly, ma'am.
Yeah, not the difference between any two squares, right?
Yeah, difference between the consecutive square numbers, exactly. Yeah.
So it seems it's working. We don't know for sure.
Later on, I've not checked. Only in the beginning I checked.
That's fine. I mean, so right now we think that this it works for this. Okay. Then Suniti ma'am says increasing in odd 1, 3, 5. So is that the same thing that you are also saying, Suniti ma'am? That the difference is 1, then 5, then 7, and then 9?
Mummy, yes, exactly the same thing. The way sir has said, the same thing I wish to convey. And probably when we are teaching this chapter, the same pattern was being taught also. That they increase in this odd ways only 1, 3, 5, 7, 9.
So Santosh Kumar, sir, you said plus 5, plus 5, plus 7.
Yes, ma'am. Same pattern, ma'am. The way other people are talking, same way.
Same thing, okay. So is there anybody? So there is Vanshika ma'am who is saying squares of even, odd. Can you elaborate, ma'am? Or I will try to, if you can unmute, otherwise I will try, interpret what you're saying and you can just say yes or no.
Ma'am, can you try unmuting? Or if you need help, Vanshika, just let me check. Vanshika, you said, no?
Yeah, Vanshika said, yeah. Yeah, Vanshika, ma'am.
I have asked her to unmute.
She said she has written a message. Okay, so...
okay, Vanshika, go ahead, Aloka. I think she is unable to unmute or something.
So, yeah. Vanshika, ma'am, I'm going to interpret what you said. You're saying that the square of 2 alternative plus 1 minus 1. So you're saying that in the squares, the even and the odd alternate. So if there's an odd, then there's an even, then there's an odd, there's an even, right? Yeah. So they alternate. Nice. Yeah. Then there was somebody, Jasmeet. Oh, hi, Jasmeet. So Jasmeet saying that difference between consecutive number is following AP in arithmetic progression. So the same thing, right? 1, 3, 5, 7. Is that the like arithmetic progression with common difference 2? Is that what you're saying, Jasmine? Hello. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. And then Sangeeta ma'am, are you also saying the same thing, right? The alternating thing. That the even and odd alternate. Yes.
Am I?
Yeah, hello.
Yes, ma'am. Somebody. Am I?
Yeah, Vijaya ma'am.
Yes. Tell me. One more thing, you just notice it in number place. Okay. 1 plus 2 is 3. In square place, 4 minus 1 is 3. Similarly, 2 plus 3 is 5. 9 minus 4 is 5. Okay. 3 plus 4 is 7. 16 minus 9 is 7. This is also another one.
Yeah. Can you just say it again? I will. That's a nice pattern. So you're saying, okay, let me say it and you tell me whether I'm correct. So you're saying 1 plus 2 is 3 and 4 minus 1 is 3.
4 minus 1 is 3. Okay.
2 plus 3 is 5 and 9 minus 4 is 5. Is that what? 2
plus 4 is 7. 16 minus 9 is 7.
That's very nice.
5 plus 4 is 9. 25 minus 16 is 9. If you see all, everything you will get same.
So, what Vijaya ma'am said, is the pattern clear to everybody or I will repeat it again?
Please type yes in the chat if it is clear for you. Shweta Hariya wants you to repeat.
I will repeat.
Aloka, I think if you can use the cursor to show,
yeah,
or do you want annotation rights? I don't know if they are there.
No, I think it's fine. I mean,
use the cursor. Go ahead.
Yeah, just use the cursor. Okay, so what she's saying is, and Vijaya ma'am, you can stop me at any time if I make a mistake. So what she's saying is that, so look at these two consecutive numbers. So you have 1 and 2. So you add these, so you get a 3. Then you look at the squares and you subtract the smaller one from the larger one. So in this case, 4 minus 1 and you get a 3. So you look at this, you have 1 plus 2 is 3, and then you have 4 minus 1, which is also 3, right? Similarly, she's saying, look at 2 and 3, so 2 plus 3 is 5, and then 9 minus 4 is 5. And she's saying that this happens to every pair that you see. So 4 plus 5 is 9, and 25 minus 16 is 9. Similarly, you can go to larger numbers, and she says that it will work there also.
ऊपर वाले जो नंबर्स हैं उनको ऐड सॉरी ऊपर वाले नंबर्स जो है उनको ऐड कर रहे हैं और नीचे वाले जो दो नंबर्स हैं उनको सब्ट्रैक्ट कर रहे हैं छोटा वाले को बड़े वाले में से और उनका सेम आ रहा है. हां
राइट. ओके सो नाउ वी हैव गॉट अ लॉट ऑफ पैटर्न्स राइट अ हेल लॉट ऑफ पैटर्न्स. नाउ माय क्वेश्चन टू यू इज दैट 1 plus 1.
There is one more from Reena Mishra, Aloka. N plus 1 ka square for all n equal to whole.
Matlab kya plus...
ma'am? Thoda bol ke batayenge madam. Aap ye kuch interesting point lag raha hai. Unmute karke batayenge please. Reena Mishra madam.
Ma'am, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
सोच रही थी कि n प्लस 1 का होल स्क्वायर जहाँ पे n जो है वो होल नंबर को बिलोंग करता है 0 1 2 3 4 फिल करेंगे तो ऊपर जो है नीचे स्क्वायर वाले नंबर्स आएंगे और n जो है वो ऊपर वाले नंबर्स को बिलोंग करेगा और n प्लस 1 का स्क्वायर जो है वो नीचे वाली लाइन को स्क्वायर.
राइट. Yeah.
Aloka, can you just repeat once more in English also?
No, Reena ma'am, can you repeat? I actually got missed a couple of.
Reena ma'am, ek bar repeat kar dijiye please. Sorry. Fir se. Ha.
Yes, madam. Mujhe main kuch aisa soch ke isko likhi hu ki n plus 1 whole square of n plus 1 where n belongs to whole number. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. If you substitute 0, then 0 plus 1 square is 1. 1 plus 1 is equal to 2. 2 ka square 4. Aisa ye ek pattern milega humko.
But this pattern kya hai isme? So n plus 1 the whole square. So humne to square hi liya hai na?
Series. Ma'am, isko hum series keh sakte hain kya? Series.
Yeah, we can call it a series. You can usually series ye mein additions hota hai. So you can call it a sequence.
Yes, sequence. Yes, ma'am.
So it's a sequence. And so Arun Kumar sir has actually elaborated on what Vijaya ma'am said, and he has actually tried to open it up. So this is good because this is exactly where I was going to come to. So now my next question to you is, we have come up with, each of you have come up with a lot of patterns, right? So look at those patterns, your patterns, your friends' patterns, all the teachers' patterns, and verify whether your patterns hold for all natural numbers now. Now, what you did was you only checked up from 1 to 20, right? I mean, Vijay ma'am's pattern, we only checked for 1 to, actually, we didn't even check for 1 to 20, but we are assuming that.
एक चीज और याद आ रही है वैदिक गणित में ये दिया हुआ है कि किसी भी नंबर का जो स्क्वायर है वो आप बिना स्क्वायर निकाले कैसे फाइंड कर सकते हैं, जैसे 46 या 40, वैदिक गणित में एक चैप्टर है मैम क्लास 9th में, उसमें ये वाला
दिया गया है मैम वैदिक गणित देख सकते हैं, लेकिन अभी आपने ढूंढ लिया तो आपने जो बोला है उसको आप अगर अलग तरीके से देखोगे तो आपने नेक्स्ट नंबर का स्क्वायर निकाल लिया है ना। आपने कहा कि अगर दो का मैं सम लेती हूँ तो वो स्क्वायर का डिफरेंस है, तो जस्ट आपको एक नंबर उस तरफ ले जाना है और आपका नंबर बन गया। सोचिए थोड़ा। बट ओके, सो नाउ व्हाट आई वांट यू टू डू इज, सो यू whatever patterns you have, please like try to verify it from 1 to, instead of 1 to 20, now look at for all natural numbers. So pick up any natural number and see whether the pattern that you have thought about actually works for some natural numbers. Am I clear in what I'm saying?
Yes, ma'am.
Am I clear? So, jaise ki,
yes.
या विजया मैम ने कहा था वो दो नंबर्स का, तो नाउ यू ट्राई 5 for 26 and 27, यू कैन यूज अ कैलकुलेटर, आई हैव नो प्रॉब्लम, एंड सी वेदर इट वर्क्स फॉर 26 फॉर एग्जांपल, दैट इज 26 प्लस 27 द सेम एज 27 स्क्वायर माइनस 26 स्क्वायर।
तो अभी तक जो हम सिर्फ 20 तक देख रहे थे, अभी हम सभी नेचुरल नंबर में सोचेंगे कि ये जो आपने पैटर्न निकाला है ये सभी नेचुरल नंबर के लिए लागू होता है कि नहीं।
Yes, the numbers, the squares number is down. The downstairs is the squares sequence. Yeah, you're right. Okay. So now, if there are, so Arun sir has actually put us on a very right path. So what he did was he, whatever Vijaya ma'am said, he tried to put it in N, right? As soon as you put N, then you move away from numbers, one specific number to all numbers. So what he did was he actually put us on a track and he said, okay, so Vijaya ma'am, so whatever Vijay ma'am suggested, Arun sir actually tries to make it into something which we can be done for all numbers. So that's exactly what we will do next. We'll like look at one of the patterns that we have and we will try to prove it. Like each, like, you know, so you can take some time out and do it, unmute yourself once you're finished, or we can proceed, and you can always do this in the next session. So you can come up with your own patterns in the next session with the proof and the verification. So I'm just going to give you a couple of minutes and then I'm going to move ahead. So one or two people who came up with their own patterns and approved. So Vijaya ma'am, if you can think of yourself, similarly with Chitra is saying, have we taken different numbers here? There is a pattern. I actually did not get your question, Chitra. I'm sorry.
Have we taken the difference of the number and its squares?
Oh, okay. So, saying it's 4 minus 2. Are you saying that, Chitra?
Yes, yes, ma'am.
So, is there a pattern there that you can see?
Yes, yes.
So, tell me.
So, like 4 minus 2 is 2, then 9 minus 3 is 6, 16 minus 4 is 12. So, when I mean, see the numbers that are above it, like 2, 6, 12, 30, then the numbers are increasing by, like, first is the difference of 6 and 2 is 4, then 12 and 6 is 6, 20 and 12 is 8. So it is increasing by 2.
The difference. Wow.
Yeah.
Is that clear what Chitra said, or should I elaborate on what Chitra said? No, it's not clear. So I'll tell you what Chitra said. Otherwise, I'll try to write it down later sometime. Yeah. Okay, so what Chitra said was this, that she said that, okay, let's look at the difference. So the difference between, say, the difference between the square and the number. So you have 1 minus 1, which you get a 0. Then you have 4 and 2, which is a 2. Then you have 6 and 3, which is a 6. A 9 and 3, which is a 6, right? So you have 0, 2, and 6. Now she's saying, look at these differences of these differences. So between 0 and 2, there's a difference of 2. Between 2 and 6, there's a difference of 4. Between 6, am I correct? Between 16
six and 12.
Right. So then 6 and 12 is a difference. I people can think about it. Till then, I try to write it down. Yeah. Give me a couple of minutes. Till then, people can actually think. And this is not necessary, and people have got it. Yes, everybody is understood. So, okay, I don't need to draw it. But that's a beautiful pattern, Chitra. So it is actually now you're going beyond the numbers and the squares, and then you're looking at a difference and then looking at a pattern in the differences. So it's a tall order to prove. So, yeah, go ahead. And I mean, maybe I'll give some more time for the proof. Do we move ahead, or you want a couple of minutes, at least one, like the start of a pattern of you proving?
Ma'am, I want to say something.
Yes, ma'am.
In number series, it is 1. And in square series, it is, if I consider it is 1 square, then it is 1. And in the second number series, it is 2. Then square series, it is 2 square equal to 4. Yeah. And in number, it is 3. And in square series, it is 3 square equal to 9.
Yeah. You're right. That's the table. I mean, the table is made like that. You're right. Nice. So, Jasneet is actually saying, I mean, a lot of complicated patterns are coming across. So what Jasneet is saying is, she's saying that, Jasneet, you correct me if I'm wrong. So, she's saying, let's look at it diagonally. So, you have 1 into 4 is 4 minus 2 into 1 is 2. So, 4 minus 2 is 2. Then 2 into 9 is 18 minus 3 into 4, which is 12. So 18 minus 12 is 6. So the initial difference is 2. Then there is a 6. Is that correct? Am I correct, Jasmine?
Yes. So we are getting 2, 6, 12, 20, 30. And if you see the difference, we get 4, 6, 8, 10. And that difference is actually an arithmetic progression with a difference of 2.
Is it clear to people what Jasmine said? Otherwise, I'll write the pattern that is coming for the differences. Yeah, it's clear. So we actually saw that note. Okay, ma'am. So let me explain once again. So what she's saying is this, that you look at 1 into 4, you get 4. And 2 into 1, so that's 2. So you get, look at 4 and minus 2, so that's a 2. Okay. Then she's saying that you look at 2 into 9, that is 18, and 3 into 4, which is 12. So 18 minus 12 is 6. Okay. Okay, the next one. So 3 into 16 is 48, right? Is it 48? Yeah.
Yes, ma'am.
So, 3 into 16 is 48 minus 36. That is 12. Right? So, look at this. So, you have 2, 6 and 12. So, the difference is 4 and then 6. And then she's saying next one would be 8. So, that's what is happening. Santosh Kumar, so you want to say something?
No, ma'am. That calculation is correct.
Yeah. Okay. So, is this okay? What Jasmine said, these are very nice patterns. And actually, you know, I would really like to tell you this every time, absolutely every time I take this session with either teachers or students, I actually come across patterns that I had never noticed. So that's one beauty of this activity. I mean, you know, I can just, I mean, and you'll also see some of the things that the children have also come up with. And it's very nice to see this. Yeah.
So, Aloka, if you don't mind, I just wanted to also emphasize this point that, I mean, I wanted teachers to just think, like, if we give this activity to students, what kind of patterns will they come up with? Just think about it, and please do also try it out with the students and see what kind of patterns they come up with on their own without being told. That is important.
Yeah, I have been bowled over. I mean, there have been patterns which, when the first, especially the first couple of times when I asked to this activity with children, they came up with patterns and we really were stumped. I mean, I didn't know how to react because they seemed not, they didn't seem true, but we didn't know how to deal with them. And they actually turned out to be true also. So yeah, let's go ahead. I'm going to move ahead now. And what you can do is like look at this and like do the same thing later on with all the patterns you have, you can actually do. Okay, so I'll move ahead. Okay, so these are some of the patterns that children came up with. And actually, interestingly, a lot of us also came up with this. So square of even number is even, odd number is odd. Difference of consecutive square numbers are consecutive odd numbers. So that's a bit stronger than what you said. If they're actually saying it's consecutive. So not just odd numbers, but it's consecutive odd numbers. Then squares of numbers ending with 0, 1, 5, 6 also end with 0, 1, 5, 6 respectively. Then sum of the number, it's consecutive number, and the square of the first number is equal to the square of the next number. I'll come to this thing, and we'll also try to look at this from the point of view of, I think, Vijaya ma'am, conjecture, and see what is similar between the two. And in the square row, odd and even alternate, this is, I think, what Sangeeta ma'am had come up with. So we actually can see that some of the things that children come up with are very similar to the patterns that like we adults come up with also. Yeah. So just give me a minute, Arun sir. But I'll remember this and I will quote you later.
Yes,
I'll
ma'am.
Come to this. So yeah. Okay. So let's see, look at this pattern of the one that I said I'll come back to. So you have the number and then the number next to it. So it's 1 + 2 + 1 gives you a 4. So it's like a ulta L. The ulta L actually gives you a number here. Right. Similarly, you can see 2 + 3 is 5 + 4 is 9. And this is, if you can see, can you see that there is some similarity to what Vijaya ma'am has said in this? Can you see the similarity?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
You're just basically moving one the number, the square of the number on the other side, on the right side. So you're adding the 3 instead of subtraction. But this pattern looks very pretty. I mean, I personally really like this pattern where, you know, I was stumped when the child gave me this. He actually said that he just drew that L and said, this gives me this. Like, it's actually like this arrow that this is exactly what he had drawn in his book when he showed it. And it took me some time. But what I wanted you to also remember is that we haven't proved these. We don't know whether they're true for all numbers yet. Is that clear to everybody? That we haven't proved it. I mean, you might have, but we haven't, as a collective, we haven't proved it. Is that fine? Yeah. Okay. So right now, we think that's a beautiful pattern and we think that it works, but we don't know for sure. Yeah. So this is, okay. I'll tell you one more pattern, which again stumped me. And this actually came from a school in Osmanabad. So which was, where there was a lot of language struggles and things like that. And even then, like, it was a very nice thing. So this is what the girl does. So it is 1 + 4 = 5 + 3 = 9, is 8 + 1 gives you the square. Is the pattern clear?
Can you repeat it once more, Aloka?
Yeah.
Ma'am, excuse me. Sorry to disturb you. Actually, in that previous one, you were saying that we have not yet proved whether it will hold every time. But if we take the first number to be n, and the next...
Arun sir, just give me 1 minute. I was saying as a collective, we haven't proved it. I'm very sure individually in yourself, you have proved it.
Okay.
We haven't proved it. That's all I said.
Yes. Yeah, okay, yeah. Ma'am. Yes.
I'm very sure that that's what I said. So most of you must have proved it in your notebook, but as a collective, we haven't seen the proof.
Okay, yes, ma'am.
That's fine, Arun sir?
Yes, ma'am.
So I'll move ahead. Okay, so Ruchi told me to repeat
it. Aloka, you have to repeat the pattern, please.
So this is, 1 plus 4 is 5, plus 3 is 8. Then you add 1 more to it, and you get 9. Okay, so basically the sum of the number, the square of the next number, and the number next to it, plus 1, gives you the square of the next number.
Means each place,
amazing.
Every time we have to add 1, right?
Yes, every time you have to add 1.
But it's really amazing that a student can come up with this. Can notice, and because this is something not linear, and we expect students to come up with something linear, something numbers which are close together, or at most with addition and subtraction. But this is like a bit of a complex one. Yeah.
So, Riya ma'am, you're saying V plus 1 as in there's a V that you see plus 1, right? Because yes. I said L?
Yeah, maybe. Yes, yeah. That is the maybe I'm connecting it.
Yeah, that's fine. I mean, it's nice. No, it's V plus 1. So, it's like where else you see the 1, but yeah. So, you're right. But is this pattern that comes up, is it true or not, right? That's one important thing to know. But more importantly, this is like as... A lot of you seem to be very amused by this pattern. So one of the things that one can do when one comes from, like when children do patterns, is that children actually make their own mathematics, because they come up with things that they have never seen before. They come up with things that even we haven't seen before, right? And like one knows in mathematics is a tradition that if somebody comes up with something for the first time, then you give it their name, like Pascal's triangle, Pythagoras theorem. So for example, in our classroom, we actually call this Pratibha's pattern, because Pratibha came first with it, no? So we actually called it Pratibha's pattern, and every time, whenever we're discussing this pattern, we actually used to keep on coming back to it and mentioning it as Pratibha's pattern. And what you see is that and it became a norm of, you know, naming it and owning it. So like even people used to come up with a pattern, children used to come up with a pattern of their own and then give it their name. And they say, okay, it's Rishabh's pattern and it's Pratibha's pattern. And I think that is extremely important, that children own the mathematics. And I think when we do our textbook mathematics, hardly gives us that chance. I mean, it doesn't give us as teachers a chance to own it, forget children who are learning it, right? So, but this is Pratibha's pattern. And for me, it will always remain Pratibha's pattern. I mean, if I go to another classroom and somebody else gives it, that in that class, the name might change. But in my head, it's Pratibha, because Pratibha came up with it for the first time. So yeah, is that fine? Can I move ahead?
Yes,
is there anything that anybody wants to discuss up till now? Or otherwise, I'll move ahead.
I think there are more patterns coming up in the chat, that's all. As
you go ahead. One more. Let me just deal with this and then go ahead.
Tapan so, Shukla says,
One more interesting pattern is you take the difference of 2 and 6, which is 4. But the difference of the square is 32, which is a product of subtraction of chosen numbers. Wait a minute, I'm totally confused. Sir, which one do you want me to explain, Pratibha's pattern?
Okay, no, the one which I...
Before that, somebody has written saying, please extend one more time.
Okay.
I'm just asking which one more time and which pattern, your pattern or Pratibha's pattern? Tapansa's pattern or Pratibha's pattern? Which do you want to be explained first? Okay, somebody has said, Nutan ma'am has said 3 into 2 Pratibha's pattern. Okay, so Tapansa first, I will explain Pratibha's pattern. To sir, and then you explain your pattern to me. Is that okay, Sapan sir? Yeah, okay. So, I just... I need to Yeah. So this is it. So you have 1, then you add the square of the next number, which is 4 in this case. So it's 1 plus 4 is 5. Then you add the third number. This is 3 in this case. So it's 1 plus 4 plus 5, which is 8. And then you add 1 to it, and you get a 9, which is the square of 3. Is that fine now, sir? So if you want, one can also look at it like this. The sum of the number, which is 1, square of the next number, which is the square of 2, which is 4, and then the number next to it, which is 3. So 1 plus 4 plus 3 plus 1 gives me the square of the next number, which is 3. So it's 1 plus 4 plus 3 plus 1 is 9. You can also look at it in this form, that x plus 1 the whole square plus x plus 2, whole is added, 1 is added to it, and you get x plus 2 the whole square. Yeah. Okay. Now, Tapan sir, your turn to explain what you were saying. And then Nutan ma'am, what you were saying.
So the thing what I want to explain is that let's have taken 2 and 6 as a random numbers. Okay. And the difference of 2 and 6 is 4. And the difference of their square, which is 4 and 36, is 32. Now that 32 is the product of, if I add 2 and 6, which is 8, and if I take 2 and 6, difference is 4. So which is 8 times 4 always. It works for any numbers.
No, I didn't get it. So 32 is what? 2 plus 6 into 4. Are you saying that?
Yeah, so the 2 and 6, the numbers which I've chosen. So if I add them, it's 8. And if I take the difference of that number 2 and 6, which is 4. So 8 times 4 give me 32, which is the difference of the chosen number squares.
Okay, yeah. Well, got it. Do I explain what Tapan sir said, or it was clear? Yeah, absolutely. They will definitely come up with more games, rupees. So do I explain? Yeah. Tapan sir, is it okay if I explain what you said using the chart I have?
Yeah, sure, ma'am.
I'm just trying to get the board without the arrows. Yeah. So what Tapan sir is saying is that you look at this, say, any two numbers. So you have 3 and say 5. Okay. So then you look at the square of 3 and 5. So you have 9 and 25. Okay, then he's saying that you add them. So you get an 8 here, and then you subtract this. So 25 and 9. So 25 and 9 is how much is 25 and 9?
34.
Huh?
25 plus 9.
25 minus 9, no?
That is 16.
16, right? Yeah. So then he's saying that, so you have 8 and 16. So then you can also, So 8 plus 5 is, 3 plus 5 is 8, right? So this divided by 16 gives you what, sir?
Means that is 2n.
That is
double.
The difference of the numbers and the sum of the numbers, their product.
So 5 into 5 minus 3 and 5 plus 3. So multiply 8 into 2, 16.
That is equal to 5 square minus 3 square. So that will obviously, yes, that's true.
Yeah, so Teja sir is saying, Teja sir, is that correct? So he's saying that it's an identity, and you can see which identity he's talking about. But still, I mean, Tapan sir first told me I did not see the identity, but now I can see it. Can people see the identity to what was?
Yes, ma'am. A square minus B square.
Yeah,
equal to a plus b into a minus b.
Square, yeah, it's b square minus a square divided by b square minus a square is a minus b into b, b minus a, right? A plus b into b minus a. Yeah, yeah. No, you can do a lot. It's not just algebraic identities. I mean, you can do a lot of things with this. Yes, algebraic identities can be one of the shootouts of this. I agree, and it has. But I think there are a lot more things that can happen, and if time permits, I'll also show you some proofs, I mean, some video, one video of where, you know, what happens in the classroom when such things happen. Yeah. Okay. So do I move ahead? Is that okay?
Aluka, just wanted to ask one more thing. Like, what is the purpose of doing this pattern? Is it to motivate students to explore patterns and identify their own mathematics in it? Is it the purpose is to explore the identities within algebra or to introduce algebra? So if you just elaborate about that a bit, maybe we can understand a bit more about how the patterns itself can be content in some ways.
One thing I said was this, that, you know, this whole thing about owning mathematics and the fact that mathematics is extremely alienating and it alienates children. It doesn't feel as if it's their own. So that is one thing, that you actually construct your own mathematics. And it's not like somebody hundreds of years ago did something, now I'm just sitting in my classroom and studying it. So that's one thing. Another thing is that the way one of the teachers said that you are actually introducing newer things, like, you know, algebraic, algebraic identities, which actually just came up when we did it. We just came across our algebraic identity. So yes, then the fun part said generalization and reasoning skills. And I will come to one of the reasons why I like doing patterns and these kinds of things. I'll come to the main purpose of it in the last part of this talk. Hi Nanda. So I will go to the next. There's another conjecture again, stumped us, and but for different reasons why it stumped us. So this is what the thing was, is that this is the child sees this and says this n plus 1 raised to 4. May he actually said square, but okay, so n plus 1 raised to 4 minus n raised to 4 is always divisible by 5. What do people see? Like if your class, if one of your students in the class comes up with this, what will you do?
How will you react as a teacher? What will you do
if you can? Or share? A classmate? I mean, like, how would you react if one of us has given this?
Apply it to few random numbers and be convinced.
Yes, absolutely. I did the same. So do we do it together or you want to like do it in your notebooks right now?
We've done it. It's applicable.
Chika ma'am, you're saying that?
Yeah.
Okay. Anybody else? Tied it in some other way?
If you
but I find by, that it is not applicable.
If you go by identity also.
Factorizing, yeah. Factorizing is, this was given to me. It was a guy, it was a boy called Rishabh, I think, who gave it to me. And as Shikha ma'am said, I just put in some numbers and you know, it seemed to work. So like, for example, I verified, so I tried for n is equal to 1 and then it was 1 plus 1, so 16 minus 1 is 15, so it's 2, right? Then I tried for n is equal to 2 and then it was n plus 1 is to 4 minus 2 is to 4, so 81 minus 16 is 65, it's also 2. Then is n is equal to 3, 3 plus 1 is to 4 is minus 3 is to 4. Is 256 minus 81 again, right? So does that mean the conductor is true because it's tried for various things and it thinks it's true?
For n equal to 4, it's not working, ma'am.
Right. Mm-hmm. So then I actually looked at, you know, I just looked at it and I realized, when I looked at it, I just said that if n is equal to 5, it will not work. So n is equal to 4 also, it does not work. You're right. So let's try for another. Shikha ma'am, you're saying something?
No, I was not. No.
Jasneet is saying how about we prove it with induction.
See, that's the thing, Jasneet, that like induction, you already need an answer and you have to assume that it's true. This might just work for induction, but it is actually not true. Right? So that's not exactly what I'm saying. That when a student comes up with something in the classroom, we need to also figure out how to deal with it. I mean, when they can come up with, it's not applicable for not just n is equal to 4. It is not applicable for n is equal to 5, or rather any number less than any divisible by like any number which is one less than a multiple of 5. So it won't be applicable for 24, for example, or right, because one of them will be a multiple of 5 and the other one will not. So you are already like, so this, it doesn't work for n is equal to 4, right? So it's not true, right? So what happened here is that, so I've been using this word conjecture all the time, and I'm really sorry, I didn't elaborate it. But is it clear what I mean by conjecture?
Can anybody share? Yeah. Taking a few examples and based on those few examples, coming to a conclusion, does that what it mean?
I mean, conjecture means that I look at something and I generalize it and I say this is true. For example, particular line here, n plus 1 is to 4 minus n is to 4 is always divisible by 5, is a conjecture, right? It's a conjecture that Rishabh made. Yeah, it's tentatively true. Yeah, I mean, it's an informed decision, but it need not be true. Right, it seems to be true, but not proven yet, right? Right, so, okay, great. So, sorry, I forgot to talk about conjectures, but yeah, I think all of you are on the same page. So, what we did was here was that it should give us a conjecture. And then we came up with an example to show that this conjecture is not true, right? So such conjectures are actually called counter examples because they are countering the conjecture, right? So it's a counter example, right? So these are some terminologies that I have been using. I have a conjecture, I use verification, I use counter example, and I will come and put all of them together in one picture and see what it does in mathematics. Yeah. Is that fine? Is everybody with me still? And how, oh my God, I've run short of time like crazy. Anyway, okay. Yeah, fine. Okay, let's look at pattern set 2, okay? It's clear, right? I've just written numbers in 4 columns, 8 columns. Is it clear? Is the image visible to everybody?
I think those who are seeing in laptop, it might be visible, but not so for the phone.
You have to do a full screen. Phone, you have to do a full screen and expand.
Full screen and you have to zoom in, like do this zoom in, you will be able to see.
Yeah, but I'm sorry. I mean, I couldn't do much. I mean, it had to write 416 words in the screen. I had to do this, so I'm sorry. Oh, okay. So I'm moving ahead. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to mark out the squares in these. Okay, so you can see that I have marked out some squares. When I did it with students, I used to give them in this form and then tell them to complete it. But because unfortunately we are in an online mode, so I just do it myself. So these are the ones. Now what I want you to do is look at these things and like, can you see any patterns in the columns now? Can you see any patterns in the column? Is my question clear?
Yes, we can see. I think people are figuring out.
Right. So all the square numbers are in the first, fourth, and the eighth column. Great. Anything else? Like what kind of numbers are in this, say the first column? Or what
it,
kind of
it is, excuse me, ma'am, it is 8m plus 1, 8m plus 4. Like leaving remainders 0, 1, and 8.
Okay, yeah. 0, 1, and 8.
0, 1, and 4.
4, huh? Okay, right. So Ria ma'am is saying that in the first column, all odd numbers are there. Fourth column, all even numbers. And what about the eighth column, ma'am? Ria ma'am? Right. So fourth and eighth are both even numbers. So there is something else that is happening there. Right?
And first column all are ending with either 1 or 9. All the numbers are ending with either 1 or 9. First column. No,
I didn't get
that. No. Sorry. I'm sorry. Yeah. On the second sheet, the first 225 doesn't end with 1.
Yeah, so one thing that Zia ma'am said was that in the first column, all of them are odd, squares of odd numbers, right? And in the fourth and the eighth, here are squares of even numbers. But can we say something else now? It means even numbers. Same. Okay, so... do people want me to wait and people are thinking still? Okay, I'll wait. Right. So all odd numbers, all odd squares end with 1, 5 and 9, no, Chitta? Isn't that correct? Is there any other? No. 1, 5, 1, 9, yeah. Right, so all odd numbers in the first column. Right, so that I think is that okay with everybody? Or is there somebody still questioning that? That we feel that, again we feel only, yeah, because is there something special about column 8? You tell me, Jasmeet. But that's a good point. That odd numbers are one more than multiple of 8. Yeah. That's a nice way of looking at it. And actually, you can see why it works. Right. Usually take columns of 10. But actually, there are ways where we take columns of 4, but we don't really write them in columns of 4. And I'll come to that also, if time permits. I mean, I'm really running short of time. I think Ruchi will soon just push me out of the room. So, yeah. Okay, so what is special about 4 and 8? So Rupesh came up with one more. He says that all odd squares are one more than multiple of 8. So like 1, of course, but 9 is 8 plus 1, 25 is 24 plus 1, 49 is 48 plus 1. So yeah, for fourth column, it's 4 into 1, okay? 4 into 3. Well, need some, I didn't get you, ma'am. Bhupendra sir, are you saying something?
In fourth column, we are multiplying that 4 with odd numbers.
Ah, okay. Got you now. Yeah. So, who said this?
Vijaya.
Vijaya ma'am. So, Vijaya ma'am said that in the fourth column, all the squares, all the numbers are multiplied, are 4 into odd number.
Odd numbers.
What does that mean? What does that tell us about the 8th row? So that means the numbers in the 4th row are not multiples of 8, right? They're multiples of 4, but not 8. So what does that tell us about the 8th row?
Just want to clarify what I was getting that Veena ma'am is saying the same, like 4 into first column squares of in the first column that we are multiplying to get square numbers of the four column. I mean, like 4 we are getting from 4 into 1 and 36 we are getting 4 into 9, that is the second square.
That's
of nice. That
oh wow, that's another and, beautiful. Yeah, got it.
And sorry, 100 sorry. I'm getting 4 into 25, that is the third square of this. Similarly, 196 is we are getting 4 into 49, so that is the fourth number.
Vijaya ma'am, are you saying that?
Pardon ma'am?
Did you say the same thing? That so 4 is basically 4 into 1, 36 is 4 into 9, 100 is 4 into 25, and 196.
This is also another pattern.
So yeah. Who explained before, ma'am, who explained this pattern?
Jasneet. I was so just asking. I mean, is it the different?
It works, yeah. It will work. So you can call it Jasneet pattern now from now on. But you can fit into it. Yeah. So all numbers in column 8 are multiples of 8. Correct. Absolutely. All numbers in column 8 are multiples of 8. So I'm going to now go ahead and... I'm going to put five numbers. And what I want you to do is tell me where each of the numbers will fit, in which column will each of the squares fit. So where will 75 squares fit? What do people see? People can just type it. So where will, so you can type it as A1, B3, whatever. You got my point, no? So it will look like this. I mean, I'm not putting in correct answers, okay? So something like this. So, yeah. I can't hear somebody, it's not clear. ये पैटर्न देखना है कुछ अब पता चल रहा है कि 75 स्क्वायर कहाँ बैठेगा क्या लगता है ये तो क्लियर है वी जस्ट सेड इट नो सम टाइम अगो कॉलम 1 राइट सो फर्स्ट विल सिट इन कॉलम 1 अबाउट 96 स्क्वायर वेयर विल इट सिट
इन 8th कॉलम
8th कॉलम या चित्रा इज सेइंग 4th why do you think it is?
Maybe because 8 ka square jo 64 hai wo bhi usi column mein hai isliye.
Which one?
I think because 96 square is a multiple of 8.
Yes, of course, 96 is the multiple of 8. So in 8th column, we will get that 96 square.
Right, absolutely. What about 122 square? Somebody is saying something. 122 square? Okay, my hint to you is that 122 is not divisible by 4.
No.
So can 122 square be divisible by 8?
122 square will be in the fourth column, ma'am.
Right, it will be in the fourth column. Perfect.
Actually, the simple technique I think we can adopt is divide the number base with 8. And there are only three possibilities. We get either 0 or remainder or 1 or 0, 1 or 4.
Right.
Based on that, we can decide.
Right. So if a number is divisible by 4, then its square will be in the 8th column. Because it will be, if a number is divisible by, just stop me if I'm wrong. If a number is divisible by 4, then its square is divisible by 8. Is that okay? What I said? Should I type it?
Clear. Right.
Yeah. Okay. So similarly, now D will be in the eighth row and E will be in the fourth row.
Ma'am, excuse me. I think you said when a number is divisible by 4, then it is divisible by 8?
No, n squared is divisible by 8. That's what
n
I wrote.
N square you are talking about.
Yeah, yeah. If n is divisible by 4, then n square is divisible by 8.
Yeah, fine.
That's all I said. I typed it also, sir, so in the chat. Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to move ahead because I... Ruchi, can I just extend for a couple of minutes?
Sure, you can take 10 minutes.
Yeah, so these are the another set of I can share this with Ruchi and she can share it with all of you in on the Telegram or something so that you can have this pattern. But Rupesh, this is very similar to the pattern that you had talked about. It is these are different patterns, but one can see that there is some similarity. So, yeah. Afreen ma'am, let me finish now before you ask for a feedback. So, sorry, but I really exceeded my time.
So that's why we had given the time till 4:30. So that. No, it's okay, Aloka, please go ahead.
So then you have, so they're saying that the difference between two odd numbers is always a multiple of 8. The difference between consecutive odd numbers is a multiple of 8. And if 2n minus 1 is the nth odd number, then the difference between the square of the nth plus 1 odd number minus the nth odd number is 8n, right? I had actually set up things like the proofs of this and all that, but I think that Ruchi can share with you later. And I will just come down to what I had said for about the larger picture. And so I'm just moving ahead right now. And if we have time, then we can actually come up with. I just talk about this. So instead of 8,
maybe Aloka, I mean, don't worry about the time. Maybe the next week when we are meeting, maybe then at that time we can explore the thing further. And also would like, in fact, would like teachers to come up with this kind of explanation if they want. And what they want to try out, what kind of pattern they want to try out with the students. That would be really interesting. Yeah.
Fine. So this is another one. Instead of 8, you approach it in 3 and see the patterns. For this, right? Okay. I will just come back to the larger picture and I will stop there. So NCF 2006, the teaching of mathematics focus papers actually makes a very, very strong statement. And it's one of my favorite quotes. Giving importance to these processes constitutes difference between doing mathematics and following mathematics. So they're saying that if you give importance to these, whatever they call as these processes, it actually makes a difference about doing mathematics and following mathematics. Now, my question is, when they say processes, what do they mean, right? And actually, what they mean is mathematical processes. And some of you put it, generalizing, proving, all of these are mathematical processes. But the way I look at mathematical processes are actually basically mathematical processes are processes which mathematicians do mathematics, right? That's what they do. So they use these processes to do mathematics. And I wanted to show you that what we did today in this particular class, in this 1 hour, and what students did in my classes and what we saw them do is actually mathematics, actual mathematics, right? Is somebody saying something? Okay, fine. So I'll start, okay? So, so what do you mean by mathematical processes? So what we did was we stated a conductor, then we started verifying the conductor, right? Right, it's connecting and communicating. And we were doing all that. No, students said you were connecting, you were communicating. So we have a conjecture, then we verify the conjecture, right? Then we actually set out. Right, we set out and we try to find a counterexample, which you people did for the n plus 1 raised to 4 minus n raised to 4. Some of you, Arun sir, I remember, Arun sir came up with a counter example, right? So if the counter example comes, then we say that the conjecture is false, right? If you continue verifying and you seem to come into a point where you think that it is true, then you you actually go out to prove it. Once you prove it, then you can say that your conjecture is true, right? This whole process that we see on the screen is actually nothing but mathematical process. But this is a process that mathematicians do to create mathematics. And if you saw today, each of these steps is what we did today. No, we actually found a counterexample, we proved the conjecture wrong, we proved something, but most importantly, we actually came up with a lot of conjectures of our own, conjectures that we had never seen before. And I think that is one very important part of doing mathematics and making mathematics interesting. Ruchi had mentioned, and then I also mentioned, this is a part of an activity designed in this project called Vigyan Pratibha. And you can actually find more such activities and quite nice activities, mathematics and science, on vigyanpratibha.in. If you want, I can type it on this. I also would like, if you actually go and do these with your students, I would like to, like, it would be nice if you can tell me, like, the different patterns that you got, because as I said, that, like, every time I conduct this with either teachers or students, I get something new. So this is my email ID in case people want to communicate with me about this, ask me questions, give me feedback, anything. So, yeah. Thank you very much. I had a lot of fun. I hope you also had a lot of fun. If there's any feedback that you want to give me personally right now, you can. Otherwise, of course, you have the feedback form.
Sure. Any questions or feedback?
Yeah.
They are very much welcome. So we will be releasing this session on YouTube in 3-4 days. People who are member of the School Synergy Teachers Forum know that we release on YouTube and we post on the school forum also. And they can also become the member of the Synergy group if they want. We already have more than 600 people who have joined that forum. Okay. So I'll just post the link of the feedback form. Meanwhile, if you have any questions, any feedback for Aloka, please feel free to share.
Ma'am, I've shared the link for feedback.
Thank you, Shalini. I was looking for it. So Shalini has just shared the link of the Google form. Feedback form, you can go and you can fill it up. So next week, again, we are having this ideation and implementation session. This is the kind of process that we have adopted recently, that we will have one session in which there will be a facilitator sharing some idea. And in the next week, the following week, we will be having a session in which we expect you teachers to come up with some sort of idea, which is inspired by what was shared today. Maybe it can be patterns, maybe it can be a small activity that you did with a student. Even if you have done it with one student, your son or daughter, just share it with us. What was your experience? If you engaged in this process of making a conjecture and finding a counterexample for yet another pattern which was not shared today, maybe you can share that itself. So we really hope that you will engage further in this idea and will share your idea next week, because we truly believe that it is not just by listening to someone, but by doing something that you learn how to use it. And this is what even Aloka has shown us today, that doing mathematics is not that you are told a certain procedure, you learn it, and then you apply it. The similar procedure in different problems. It is the mathematics lies in identifying the new patterns and the new ways of looking at these numbers and patterns itself, and proving them also, finding a counter example or seeing whether generalizing whether it is applicable to all natural numbers or not. So I really want to thank Aloka for bringing up this creative side of mathematics and giving us an example of how even students can own their own mathematics, and also highlighted the processes of mathematics and not just the content itself. So I hope you will participate with enthusiasm in the next session, Saturday, again 3 p.m. And we'll share your examples at the School Synergy Teachers Forum. And from those examples, we will call some people to share it in the next week. Yeah, Aloka.
Can I say something?
Yeah, go ahead, please.
Yeah. Thank you very much. And I think, like, you know, a lot of what you're saying, I mean, like, oh, I think Pradyutsha said that, you know, if there was something for everybody. And that is exactly what I think these kind of open activities work out. I mean, everybody actually has something in it that they learn and they create. I mean, learn is one thing, but creating is another. And I think it's a very, very important part of liking mathematics and loving mathematics is creating mathematics. So
The creative aspect, sorry. I mean, but creative aspect is almost never experienced in our mathematics classroom, and this is a good way to do that. Please go ahead.
Yeah, I mean, I think even for all of us also, I mean, we hardly have any chances of creating mathematics, but today we did. I mean, and I again came across some patterns which I had never I've never seen before, and I've come to this session a lot of times. So thank you very much. It was really nice. I just want to add one more thing, that the patterns that you saw children make, it's a process. It's like, you know, like one child will say something. I had a video about it, which right now we don't have time, but I will show. I mean, I can share it with Ruchi, and she can share it with me. Like where you can see that one simple conjecture is building up in the classroom. So it's also this children communicating with each other. It's not just the teacher who is holding education, holding all the knowledge. It is like they're correcting each other. They're saying, no, this is not correct. This is not the correct. So, I mean, that is also very important. And I think that that's what each of us wants our classroom to be. So thank you very much. I had a good time, and thanks a lot. So
did we. We also had a good time. Yeah, there are lots of comments of appreciation. So, yeah.
Yeah, so, yeah, thanks a lot and bye.
Okay. Yeah,
all the best to all of you.
Yeah. Bye, Aloka. I'll just hang on for a few more minutes. You can log off if you want.
I will leave. Okay.
Yeah, sure.
Bye, everybody. Okay.